Jesus had completed all these things, he said unto his disciples,
ye know that after 2 days is the Passover, and the Son of Man shall be delivered over, that he may be crucified.
At that time there assembled the chief priests and the scribes together with the elders of the people unto the palace of that high priest whose name was Caiaphas. And they sought counsel to take Jesus by subtlety and kill him. But they made answer, of Simon the leper, there came unto him a woman having a box of very precious ointment, and poured it on his head as he sat at meat. But when his disciples saw it, they had indignation and said,
to what purpose is this waste, this waste, this waste, this waste, this waste, this waste, to what purpose is this waste?
All this ointment, all this ointment, all this ointment,
understood it, he said unto them,
well, for trouble ye the woman, for she hath wrought a good work on me. At all times ye have a been done to prepare me for my burial. Verily I say to you, wherever this gospel shall be preached to the people throughout the world, there too shall be told, this woman
Thank you. went one of the disciples, whose name was Judas Iscariot, to the chief priests and said,
How much will he give me if I betray him to you?
And they bargained for 30 silver pieces. And from that time he sought opportunity that he might betray him.
Thank you.
first day of the unleavened bread, came the disciples to Jesus and said unto him, to say unto him,
to betray him, and said,
"Is it I, master?"
He said to him,
"Obsessed."
And as they were Jesus took bread, blessed it, and break it, and gave to all of them, saying, took the cup, and giving thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink it all, this is my blood of the New Testament. that sung a hymn together. They went out into the Mount of Olives. Then said Jesus to them,
Holy shall be offended because of me this night. For it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep of the pasture shall be scattered abroad.
Said to him,
Go over offended because of thee, in so shall I be never offended.
Jesus said to him,
Verily I say unto thee, that this same night, ere the
said to him,
Yea, even though I should die with thee, yet will I never deny thee.
And likewise also said all the disciples. with them unto a place which was called Gethsemane, and said to his disciples,
See.
took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to be so.
My Lord, beside my And he went away, and falling upon his face, he prayed and said, My Father, if possible, so let this cup pass
the sin of men is filled. shrink, but suffer all that God hath
to his disciples and found them sleeping and said to them,
Would ye then not watch with me one single hour? Watch ye and pray ye, that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
A second time he went away, prayed and said,
My Father, if it is not possible that this cup pass away from me, except I drink it, that I will be done.
Because their eyes were heavy with sleep. And he left them, and he went away again, praying a third time, and saying again the same words. Then cometh he to his disciples and said to them,
and resting. See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man shall be given over into the hands of sinners. Arise, let us be going. See now, he is nigh that doth betray me.
While he was speaking, behold, there came Judas, one of the 12, and with him a great band of men, with swords and with staves, from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now he that betrayed him had given a sign unto them that were with him, and had said, Whomsoever I shall kiss, that is he, hold him fast. Forthwith he came unto Jesus and said,
All hail to thee, my master,
and kissed him. Jesus said unto him,
My friend, wherefore art thou come?
Then came they all around and laid their hands
hands upon Jesus and forthwith took him.
which were there with Jesus, stretched his hand out and struck the high priest-serving man and smote off his ear. Then said Jesus to him,
put up thy sword into its place. Who takes the sword, he by the sword shall perish. I cannot now pray unto my Father, and that he shall give me more than 12 legions of angels. How shall the scriptures then be fulfilled, that thus it must be?
Speak Jesus to the multitudes.
I all come out then as against the rubble, with swords and with staves wherewith to take me. Have I not daily appeared among you, and openly taught in the temple, and ye laid no hold upon me? But I tell you, all this was done that might be fulfilled. The scriptures all were prophets.
Then for
Away unto the high priest Caiaphas, where all the scribes were assembled together with the elders of the people. Simon Peter followed him from afar unto the palace of the high priest, and went inside and sat down among the servants, that he might witness what the end should be. The chief priests and elders of the people, and the council also, to find false witness against Jesus, that he might be put to death. Yet found they nothing.
Came forward, yet did they find none. At last came to them two that bore false witness, saying,
"This fellow's unable to destroy the temple of God,
and to build it in 3 days, to build it in 3 days."
The high priest therefore arose and said to him,
"Dost thou make no answer to them that bear this witness against thee?"
But Jesus held his peace.
Peace, though men accuse him falsely.
Answered and said unto him,
I adjure thee by the ever-living God that thou shalt tell us if thou be the Christ, the Son of God.
Jesus said to him,
thou sayest, but I say to you that it shall come to pass that ye shall see hereafter the Son of Man throne on the right hand of God and coming in the clouds of heaven.
Thereupon the high priest rent his garments and said,
he hath spoken blasphemy. What need then of further witness? See now, for ye have heard this fellow's blasphemy yourselves. What do ye think?
They answered him and said, and beat him with their fists. Some of the others buffeted him upon the face, saying,
now tell us, tell us, tell us.
Sat outside in the court, and there came unto him a maid, and said,
thou also was truly with Jesus of Galilee.
But he denied it before them all, and said,
I know not what thou sayest.
And when he was come out to the porch,
he was seen by another maid, who said unto them that stood by him,
This man also was with Jesus of Nazareth.
And again he denied it, and with an oath,
I do not know the man.
And after a little while, there came to him they that stood by, and said unto Peter,
Surely thou also art one of them that is with Jesus of Nazareth.
And then began he to curse and to swear,
I do not know the man.
And immediately the cock crew. Then Peter remembered the words of Jesus, which said unto him, Before the cock croweth, thou shalt deny me thrice. And he went out, and
came all the chief priests and the scribes and elders of the people, took counsel against Jesus, that they might kill him. And binding him, they led him away, and delivered him unto the governor Pontius Pilate. Then Judas Iscariot, he which had betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself, and brought again the 30 silver pieces unto the priest and the elders, and said,
I have done evil because I have betrayed the innocent blood.
They answered,
What is that to us? What is that to us? Seek out, seek out.
Cast the silver pieces down in the temple, and he went forth, departed, and he hanged himself. And the chief priest took the 30 silver pieces and said,
It is not lawful.
took counsel together, and bought the potter's field with the silver pieces for the burial of strangers. Wherefore the name of that field has been the Field of Blood, unto this very day. Then was fulfilled that which was spoken by the prophet Jeremiah, when he said, "And they took the 30 silver pieces, which was the price of him that was valued, whom they of the children of Israel did value. And they did give the pieces for the potter's field, as the Lord appointed me." Jesus therefore stood before the governor, and the governor asked him and said,
"Art thou the King of the Jews?"
Jesus said unto him,
"Thou sayest."
And when he was questioned by the chief priests and by the elders, he answered them nothing. Then Pilate said unto him,
"Hearest thou not these men's accusations?"
And he answered him to never a word, insomuch that the governor marveled very greatly. Then the governor was accustomed to release unto the people one of the prisoners, which one they would. Now at that time the governor had a prisoner, more notable than the others, whose name was Barabbas. And when they were all assembled, Pilate said unto them,
"That I release unto you, Barabbas or Jesus, of whom it has been said he is Christ?"
For Pilate knew that it was for envy that they had delivered him. And when he was at the judgment seat, came one that his wife had sent, and said unto him, "The scribes and the chief priests and the elders all persuaded the people to ask that Barabbas be released and that Jesus should perish. So
So the governor made answer unto the people, saying,
Tell me whether of the twain will ye that I release unto you.
They answered,
Thus!
And Pilate said to them,
What then shall I do unto Jesus, of whom it is said that he is Christ?
They all make answer,
Let him be
Thank you. they cry out for more and said,
let him be cruel.
He took water and washed his hands before them all and said,
I am innocent of the blood of this just person. See then ye to it.
And they answered him with one accord and said,
Thank you. soldiers of the governor take Jesus into the common hall and gathered unto him the whole band of men and stripped off his clothes and put upon his back a scarlet robe and plaited a crown of thorns and put it upon his head and a reed in his right hand and bowed the knee before him and mocking at him they said taking a reed, they smote him upon the head. the scarlet mantle off and putting again his own raiment on, they led him away that they might and as they were going out, they found by the way a man from Cyrene, who
whose name was Simon, nay, compelled him that he should bear his cross.
In truth, to bear the cross of flesh and blood, a loath to be constrained, for that which works our chiefest good, most hardly is attained.
Thank you. The place of a skull. They gave him vinegar to drink that was mingled with gall. And when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And after they had crucified Jesus, they divided his garments and cast lots for them, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophets. They parted my garments among themselves, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And they seated themselves and watched him there. And over his head was written the title of his accusation, namely, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." And there were with him two robbers crucified, one on the right hand and one on the left. And they that were passing by reviled him, and wagging their heads they mocked him, and said,
"Thou hast destroyed this temple strong, and Thank you.
The same was cast in his teeth by the robbers which were crucified with him.
Thank you. came to pass a darkness over all the land. Unto the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried aloud and said, was standing near. When they heard that, they said,
"He calleth for him, Barabbas."
And straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with some vinegar and put it upon a reed and gave him to drink. But others of them answered,
"Yes, he is saved."
Having cried again aloud, yielded up the ghost.
That was sweet.
came out of the graves after Jesus' resurrection, and went into the holy city, and was seen by many. But the centurion, and they that were with him, keeping watch over Jesus, when they looked on the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, among whom there was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of Zebedee's children. Now when evening fell, there came a rich man from Arimathea, whose name was Joseph, who was also one of Jesus' disciples. He went unto Pilate and begged from him the body of Jesus. Then Pilate commanded the body to be delivered.
Thank you. Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen cloth and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had ordered to be hewn out in the rock, and rolled a great stone up to the door of the sepulchre, and went his way. There was also there Mary Magdalene and the other Mary sitting over against the tomb. Now on the next day that followed the preparation, came the chief priests and Pharisees together unto Pilate and said,
Sir, we deliver not the Pharisees seizing us, but keep us yet time. After 3 days I will rise and tell you what it is, and I will not answer him.
And they sealed up the stone.